Howdy, folks. Kiwi here, and welcome back to Factorio Passing the Torch. I'm joined by Hero Man Bunny. What's up?
Up.
Yes. And we're just doing our best to have some fun. What were we last doing?
I don't know, but here is a thing before we get started.
Okay.
I was coming up here, and I'm checking on just these little things I was farting with them with last time.
But yeah, then, yeah.
Out of the corner of my eye, I noticed this down here. Oh, is this where we're storing all of our coal, wood, and stone that we don't use?
This is basically just an easy place for all the stuff to be unloaded when we come back from, like, removing trees and shit.
Oh, okay. Because I came down here, I was like, what the crap? Because I thought it was connected to this, but I was like, no, it can't be, because we don't use wood for anything, apparently. So I was confused, and now stereo stuck on what all this was here. Okay, all right, that makes sense. Makes sense. So why am I requesting two wall and laser turrets? Are we gonna do something today?
No, last time we just built the wall.
Okay. And the wall's finished. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Oh, now I remember what you were going to do. You were planning on radaring the entire base.
Yes.
The interior of the walls. Just put a radar, like a radar grid, so we can see literally everything happening inside.
Radars need, power. Electricity, huh?
Yeah. But that's fine, that's fine. So, here's how it will work. Because I'm in charge and I tell you what to do. You go to the bottom left, and place a radar just right there. Just make sure you can see it. And then, you notice how the each radar has its own sort of, like, lit-up square in the center, right?
Okay.
At the very right edge of the radar you place in the bottom left corner, make sure that you connect a new radar so that its lit-up square doesn't overlap. And then do that for the entire base, and that'll be your objective for today.
Alright. On it. Let's see here.
Oh, and before you go, hang on. Here's 24 radars. Feel free to take down the radars we already have up. Like, reuse them, since we're going to be making a grid anyway, so...
See, and there should be a radar at each of our little outbases.
Mm-hmm.
We'll go check on that.
Batteries could use some help. What's wrong with batteries?
What did you do to the batteries?
I mean, I didn't do anything.
Yeah. Okay. Who?
Batteries are not going because they don't have enough sulfuric acid. Okay. Sulfuric acid isn't going because of why? What reason? Enough oil.
How do I make radars? There.
Oh, we just aren't getting enough crude oil. Oh, shit.
All right.
What's wrong with crude oil? We just aren't getting enough, it seems. Looks like I'm working on trains today.
The radars I can.
Plenty of oil, so thankfully there's that. Alright, let's go fix the world.
Oh, right. We don't have a little factory making copper, do we? Or copper wire.
No.
least I won't copper wire. I know what I'm gonna do.
I mean, there's no dedicated box with copper wire, but it is being made. And also, you can just make it yourself.
Good.
Alright, so, the place I want to go is right here. This is where I want to build our oil. Perfect. Okay. If Minif Petif Hedriff. Okay, but that needs to turn now. Ooh, nice. Yeah, go past here because we'll need that copper eventually. Have like a thing here. Yes, I understand. I see the matrix.
The code. You think you see like them?
I see like them. I talk like them. I walk like them. I want to be like them. Ooh, I'm out of rail signals. Let's make some. Well, that's a shame. Out of my damn way.
There we go. So I have 100.
One honkin'.
One honkin.
Chong!
It's too much, but alright. Time to go! One thing that could have made that better is if I got hit by the train inside our base.
The classic, I say I'm going to do a thing, and then circumstances immediately determine otherwise.
Okay, I want to put the radar on my little...
Okay. I keep going further. Just keep going. Oh, hang on. Gotta reset my music. Actually, no. I'll let it loop around.
That's right, Kiwi. Just let it loop.
Well, here's the thing. In the past, I had my phone, which had, like, no music on it. I didn't connect it to anything because, well, we were just out of oil. What it was I manually put on some, like, custom albums I made with, like, 15 songs each, and there was about 6 of them. So there was only a certain amount of music on my phone, and it would loop occasionally, but I had it on shuffle, right? So I didn't want to just continuously listen to the same order of music. So what I did was I had it where it was set. What am I doing? I'm getting around. I had it set so that when a certain song played, I would then go into my playlist, tap that song, and it would refresh the music. It would refresh the entire list and the order went. And this became just what I did, you know? So, eventually, what happened was I got so used to that song was associated with resetting my music. So, when I finally put on thousands of songs onto my phone, that song was still on there. But it was, you know, all the original music was outweighed by all the new music. Yeah. So, it's a case of, fucking lost my train of thought there.
You self-change yourself to hear, when you hear that music, that song, it's gotta restart the playlist?
Yeah, and I was about to do that when I realized, Well, I mean, it's been months and months and months of listening to all these songs, and I have no regrets. I'm just gonna listen to them again.
Fair enough.
I'm going down this way. I just want to have a loop there.
Old pals, go. Rural pals. Oh, some like the rural pals just sometimes just want to be on break. You know, you'll tell them to deconstruct the forest.
You know, when I said put the radar down, I meant at the wall so we can see outside the base too.
Oh, I thought you meant like so the radar ranges. I gotcha. All right, it's all coming together now. I smell what you're stepping in.
Good.
Where's that radar?
Continue to smell that forever.
Yeah, that's knowledge.
Excuse me. So we got the patch there, patch over here, and patch way the hell down there.
I have determined that this is the far corner, and I will place it here.
See? Yeah, no, that's good. Because you'll notice that the corners of that, like the outside, the bottom wall and the left wall, well, they cover all of the interior of our base. Like right here and over here, and you can't see what I'm motioning to, but the audience can, so they know what I'm talking about, even if you don't. So do what they know that you should. I think that's my favorite, by the way. Just like telling you to do something that you can't possibly understand.
That's how I do. I like the malicious compliance sometimes, because they'll try to do that at work too. A guy will be joking with me, like after a while of like troubleshooting or whatever, he'll be like, "Okay, yeah, do this, and this," and then you know do this, and I'm like, "All right, cool," and I'm doing the steps, and like things seem to start working, and then like at the very end, he's like, "All right, then do this and this, and then do this," and like the last thing he says is very clearly something you shouldn't do. I'm just like, all right, on it. And like, I'll just say, on it, yeah, on it. And I'll post it on, and I'll start adding it to the notes. And they'll start freaking out because I sound very convincing that I actually put it on. It's like, no, what did you do? Like, yeah, here's the ticket, and here's the notes that I put in it. I did exactly what you said.
I did exactly word for word what you told me to.
Well, 1,000,000,000% faith in whatever you told me.
Yeah, no, as you mentioned, the malicious blind faith is pretty good.
You know what? Probably should have picked up the other. I want to do that now.
Now it's a lot it is a lot better when there's less on the line, I guess you could say. We're playing a video game right now. I don't care if you do exactly what I say word for word, even though it's incredibly stupid and not advisable. Because it's a video game. I wouldn't want that in, you know, anything, any important office of any type.
No, I think it's even more hilarious when I do it in the office setting, because it's strictly on them, because they can see very clearly see that I'm blindly doing whatever they tell me to do.
Yeah.
I don't know the thing, and then all of a sudden they like try to joke around with it at the very end, and then realize they've made a massive mistake.
I'd say something along the lines of you'd be great in a dictatorship, but also dictators generally don't make jokes when they make orders, so you know.
Yeah, it's true. Okay, I'm gonna. Yeah, here we go. This is what I was looking for. Hoover that up. Is there a way to make? Because I have the radar selected on my little deal, and I can see the blue areas that they cover, but like they're inside our base. Is
Okay.
there a way to make the little radars themselves light up on the base? I know exactly what to do. That's a freaking brilliant idea, Kiwi.
I'm so baffled by what the fuck you just said.
We're gonna implement it immediately. All of our sites. It's such a good idea.
What is it, and what did you say? I am legitimately so fucking confused by the wording with which you chose.
Okay, so the deconstruction plan.
Yeah.
I realized that if I right click on it inside my inventory, I can just select specific things that I want to deconstruct.
Yeah, yeah.
And I can just do that.
Yeah. What are you trying to deconstruct?
I want to deconstruct the radars inside of our base.
Oh.
Because I can't find them. I'm just going to wide sweep and clear it out to figure out where
they are. Fair. You know what? Fair enough. You've earned that. Also, I'll be honest. I knew you could do that, but I didn't think you could do it in vanilla because I've played so much modded. And I couldn't actually find it.
It's bad. It did not do the thing I wanted. Oh, I see. I see why. Whew, that was a close one. They completely destroyed this, though. I guess I gotta fix that first.
Yeah, don't break.
I will fix. All right.
I fix.
Hey, guy.
No, I don't have any of those on me. All right, I need to go get the materials for pump jacks.
This needs a...
At this point, I'm just being really petty against nature. Removing all their stupid trees.
Fair enough. It seems like nature did a lot of work putting it there.
Yeah, but why should I care? I don't. That's why I asked the question.
It's respecting the work that was put in. So, instead of deconstructing everything... Okay, there we go. And it was like nothing happened and Kiwi is none the wiser.
Where are you? Oh, there you are.
I'm nowhere and nothing's happening. Find these radars. They are, but sick 'em, rubble pals.
Okay, once you get rid of that, I want, like, 30 pump jacks.
Go up here and do that again.
There they come. Yes! Give me. Oh, since you're deconstructing all the radars, it'll likely be that the robots at the base, because they're in the zone, will take care of the radars. So when you're done doing whatever you're doing, go to the storage system and go pick up your radars.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
In fact, there's 4 in here.
Nice.
When I said that, by the way, I was really hoping that there'd be, like, way more things in the storage, so you'd have to, like, search for it. But no. That isn't the case.
Ray.
Alright, let's get back to work. Enough with the breaks.
Right, robot RoboPals. I want 1,000 radars. Search those boxes and slam them into my gullet.
Sure.
Yeah. RoboPals, go.
Nice. Yeah.
Okay, cool. That's all of them in this area. Time to move on.
No, that won't work.
No, that's not gonna work.
It won't.
No, there's a radar outside of Rubel Power range. There we go. Yeah, I found it. Get it, Rubel Pal. Thanks.
And that.
The other day, I was watching, I saw a video of, this guy basically messing around with scammers on the phone.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, all right, that's cool. A neat little video. It's cool. So then, the other day after that, I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna leave YouTube on. Fall asleep to, like, you know, the ambient sound of someone messing around, you know?
I get you.
I turn on this, so I see, oh, there's another scammer video. It's kind of funny watching these guys. And, I almost got hit by a train. Okay, and I was like, you know what, yeah, I'm just going to watch this guy, because it's pretty funny. And when I clicked on it, I didn't really look to see what the video was called.
Okay.
And this guy messes with this team of scammers for freaking 36 hours.
Okay.
Stay on the phone with him because he's got a voice modulator, so he's pretending to be like a 87-year-old woman.
Uh-huh.
And she on the phone, she sounds very, very gullible. Sure. They're trying to They're trying to make the scam is they get, it's a refund scam. So yeah. they call offering, "Hey, we got a refund for you." They remote into your computer and give you the refund, but when they do, they give you too much. Then they say, "Oh, you gotta give money back because we gave you too much."
Mm-hmm.
But they're doing this, and their plan is: you go to the store, buy Google Play cards, come back.
Oh, I know that one.
Yeah. So that's what their plan is. But this guy was like, "All right, I'm gonna go do this." And then it's like, all right, how do I do this? Oh, here we go. I just read the back of the card and scratch it off and then type in the numbers in Google Play, right? And the guy's like, no. Don't touch your computer. I want to remote in. I want to get the notepad. You'll type the number into the notepad. And because he's pretending to be like such an old lady, he's like, all right, cool. I'll type it in, and types it in. And the guy is freaking out trying to tell her to stop. And then he redeems all of them. It was a program, so it's not real money.
Yeah.
But he made it look like he deposited $2,000 of Google Play cards into his own account.
Nice.
I was like, oh, that's pretty neat. And the guy was basically, I didn't fall asleep anytime soon because I was laughing so much of this guy scamming these guys. And the best part is he's on the phone for so long. He convinces them that, okay, tomorrow I'm going to get some more cards because I messed these ones up. So tomorrow I'll get more cards and then I'll be able to redeem it. Cause like the thing the scammer is saying is we need the money back because I made a mistake. And if you don't do this, I'm going to lose my job.
Uh-huh.
So he's using that as motivation to, okay, I need to get these Google Play cards to you so I can save your job, and then you'll have a job.
Okay.
So the next day, he's making it seem like other scammers are successfully scamming them, and this original scammer is not.
Ah, yeah, no, that break the pride.
Exactly. So he's like, "Oh yeah. Earlier today, I got a mail from Google, and they said that there's something wrong with my printer. So they remote it in. And I gave them. I wrote down numbers, and they were able to take the money." So this guy's like, "No, you can't take anyone else's call. Only my call. You can't talk to anyone else." And it's basically that for. And these are long videos. He actually almost plays all 36 hours on his channel.
Yeah.
Freaking 10 videos, and they're all an hour plus.
Nice.
Eight. So, and these guys get so ridiculous because they want any kind of money any way they can.
Trust me, I know.
So eventually, they get to the point where he's like, I forget how they get to it, but he's like, "Okay, you guys got to pretend to be," because he calls them back and he gets different guys from their same call center. They're like sitting next to each other.
Okay.
So when they talk, you can hear the echo because they're in the same room.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's like, "Okay, you have to pretend to be my lawyer because they called him and said, 'Okay, we're the government. We're because you're not paying your taxes.
This is the police. This club is closed forever.'"
Exactly. So like, "Oh, we're the FBI. And you have to give us money back because you're not paying your taxes." Uh-huh. But then he calls him, like, "Don't worry, I'm gonna call my IT guy." He calls the other scammer. So the two scammers talking to each other. One scammer is pretending to be his lawyer, and the other scammer is pretending to be part of the FBI. And the two scammers are talking to each other, trying to convince the other one that they're the FBI.
God, and that's so beautiful.
Oh, dude. It just goes further and further on because there's a...
Before you continue, we should end the episode.
Oh, right.
All right. To be continued in the next episode. Thank you guys for watching. I, of course, have been Kiwi. He's my hero, man, Bunny. You've been great, too. Never change. Yourself a delightful day. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.